In this video, I will talk about the most effective way to recognize faces in your photos. Why might this be necessary? Over the years, we have accumulated huge archives of photos, where we meet friends, travel around the world, where our children grow up. And these archives can be very large, hundreds of gigabytes and even terabytes. But when there are so many of them, it becomes completely unrealistic to navigate. But what's the use of photographs if they can't be easily found and viewed? This is where the Tonfotos photo cataloging app comes to the rescue. With it, you can return to your favorite memories. For example, by shooting location, by event on the timeline, and it is especially convenient to search for the best photos of your loved ones in their personal albums. So we can quickly find the right photo to post on social networks, or pick up the right images for a congratulatory album, a short video, or print a calendar as a gift. Watch this video until the end and you will learn how to mark the faces of your loved ones in a huge number of photos with minimal effort. Tonfotos is a popular photo cataloging software. It contains modern neural networks for working with faces, and currently it provides the most thoughtful and efficient workflow for working with faces in photos. This video is based on the current version 1.21. The program is actively developing. In the future, additional features may appear to make it easier to work with faces and more. Installation. So, let's start from the very beginning. Install the program from scratch. If you already have Tonfotos installed, then feel free to skip to this timecode. We go to the Tonfotos website and download the program for our operating system. In my case, this is a MacBook with an ARM M1 processor. The download has started. You need to wait a bit until the download is over. So, as we can see, the application has downloaded. On Windows, it will be enough just to click on this file and the installation will start. On macOS, it's a little more difficult. Here you need to drag this icon into the application folder. Done! Application is installed. You can close those windows and start Tonfotos. We confirm for macOS we really want to run this application. When you first launch the application, you will be asked to agree to the terms of the license agreement. Since we are installing the free version, we need to agree to all three checkboxes here and click the Use Free Version button. Next, the program will prompt us to choose where we store our photos, and by default, we will be offered several options. You can opt out of some of them and add additional folders where your photos are stored. In this case, I'm using the default 2 and clicking the Done button. Next, the program will prompt us to choose an interface theme, light or dark. I like dark better. That's it. The program has started and the initial setup has already been completed. The program started scanning those folders that we indicated to it in the previous step. This will take some time, and the more photos you have in your archive, the longer it will take. Here, as you can see, the program shows us which files it is scanning right now and how much time is left before the end of the scan. So, we just have to wait. Finally, the scan is over. Status string down below says ready. And now we can finally move on to the next step. Now, if we switch to the people section, we will see that there are no people in the program yet. This is because our photos may contain many different people, random passersby. But not all of these people are of interest to us. It is important for us to be able to track people whom we know, our loved ones, relatives, acquaintances. In order for the program to know who to track, they must be explicitly specified. To do this, let's go back to the folder section. Since at the moment we want not just to admire our photos, but work with faces, we need to use an important tool, the File Information panel. It opens with this button. As you can see, now if we switch between files, the information in the panel is updated. It strictly corresponds to the file that is currently selected. In addition to all sorts of information, such as about the camera, the date the file was created, and so on, all the faces that were found in this photo are also visible here. Right now, I can assign these faces to a specific person. But I will not do this because I want to show you another way. Why is it not always convenient to do it here? Because, as you can see, the faces here are quite small, and if your screen resolution is not very high, it can be difficult to see who is who. So, let's switch to the photo view mode. This can be done in different ways. For example, by double-clicking the mouse. You can also press Enter or Space, and then we will switch to this mode. You can also return from it in different ways, for example, by clicking this button. Also by double-click on the photo. You can also press Escape, Enter, or Space. So, we switched to the photo view mode, and since we now have the information panel open, we have all the faces selected in the photo. If I move the mouse pointer in the information panel here, then the corresponding faces are also highlighted in the photo. If I hide this information panel, there will be no faces. With the information panel hidden, nothing should distract us from enjoying our photos. We can scroll through them, look, zoom in, zoom out, and so on. But as soon as we open the file information panel, the recognized faces are again highlighted in the photo. And now we can take a closer look at who is who and assign each face to a specific person. Let's do that. I press This Is, then New Person. In the People section, a new person is created and I can enter her name. At the same time, while I was entering the name, the program had already found many other similar faces of this person and immediately offered them to me for confirmation. We will discuss how to work with the proposed faces a little later. Now I would like to add more people to the library of the program. In fact, there is no strict sequence in which it is necessary to do this. It is only important to understand that the program is constantly learning based on what we offer it, and the more information we give it, the more accurate and better the proposals it makes to us will be. It is also important to understand that all face recognition or face matching takes place exclusively locally on your computer, and this information is not sent to any external servers. Now back to the folder section. But here we are in the very beginning of the last folder in which we were before. It's not always convenient, so I'll show you another way. We have confirmed the face from this photo, and we want to go back to the folder section specifically for this photo. To do this, you can click here. You see, we switched back to this folder, and this photo is selected. Open our photo again, and do the same operation for one more person. Now, if we select this photo again, we can see that in the information panel, the two portraits already look different. There is no longer a question mark, but a name appeared above this portrait, which indicates to whom exactly this portrait belongs. Let's open our photo again. But now, we will not switch to folder mode like last time. You can also open it from here. As in the folder section, here either double-click on the photo, press Enter, or press the space bar, and the photo will open. If now we scroll to the right and to the left, we are already scrolling not through the list of photos in the directory, but through the list of portraits in the section of this person. So, back to adding. As you certainly noticed, one of the found faces is not actually a face. This is a Christmas toy that the program mistook for a face. This happens quite rarely, but I specifically picked up such a photo where it happened. We can just remove it, either here or here. Call the context menu and select Ignore this face suggestion. When we do this, the face is completely removed from the database and will no longer be offered to anyone as a candidate. It is an obvious thing to do when application accidentally recognizes something as a face, but it is not a face. However, in some situations, we may want to remove people's faces as well. For example, when it's just some people we don't know, whom we don't want to have in our library at all. In this case, we also select Ignore this face suggestion in the same way. We can also ignore all unassigned faces. Let's try it. As you can see, now there are only those two faces that we have already assigned to people. The other two faces are completely gone. Whether this should be done is debatable. Some do it, some don't. For example, I am lazy and do not delete all unfamiliar faces from my huge photo archive. However, some users prefer to keep their archive clean and leave only faces of those people who are dear to them. And to facilitate such work, this command is quite useful. Now we've removed it, we only have two faces left on this photo. In fact, I did it solely for the purpose of an example. I don't want to delete these people. Let's bring them back. To do this, I need to right-click in the middle of the face, somewhere around the nose, and click Add New Face at this location. After that, a couple of seconds will pass and the face will be added. See? It's been added. I can do the same again for the second face. Now it has been added too. I can just as well assign this face either to a new person or to an existing one. Before discussing the work with the proposed faces, two additional clarifications need to be made. In the People section, there is an additional button in the toolbar, which is not available in other sections. This button switches between displaying portraits of people and full photos in which these portraits are located. As you noticed now, there are no buttons here to confirm that faces belong to a person. They only appear when we switch to portrait mode. This is because we are confirming specific portraits, not entire photographs. The second point, this exclamation mark next to the icon of a person in the list appears only when there are suggested faces for this person. When we confirm or reject them all, the exclamation point disappears. Now we have very few people on the list, but when there are several dozens of them, this icon will help you navigate quickly. As you can see, there are three different buttons for each photo. This button confirms that the proposed face really belongs to this person. And as soon as we pressed the button, as you saw, the program took into account the new information that we gave it and recalculated the possible options for new faces. It offered us even more faces to confirm. This button here tells the program that this is really a face, only the face of not this person. Please don't offer us that face again for this person. But this button simply removes the photo from the database, and it makes sense to press if it's not a face at all, or for example, the face of a person you don't know for sure. It works identically to the ignore this face suggestion command that we discussed earlier. More often than not, the program will suggest correctly, and we can just click and click the confirm button. You can do this not only with the mouse, you can also use the keyboard. With the right, left, up and down arrows we move in the list, and to confirm the face we press Shift Enter. To reject a face, we press Backspace. This does not remove the face, it only says that this portrait does not belong to this person, and in order to remove this face from the library, we need to press Shift Backspace. It is not always convenient to work with suggestions one at a time. The program offered us many suggestions at once, and they are all correct. Let me show you how to confirm them quickly. To do this, the proposed faces need to be selected. We click on the first photo, and then holding Shift on the last one. See, all the intermediate photos have been selected too. And now I can either press Shift Enter in the same way to confirm all selected faces, or do the same through the Confirm command in Context menu. You can also reject or delete them all at once. To cancel the selection, just click past the photo. You can also select a group from the keyboard. First, select the first photo, and then, holding Shift, press many times to the right until all the desired portraits are selected. Similarly, you can press the down button to select line by line. There's also a Control A button that selects all the photos in the group. After we confirmed, the exclamation sign in the people list disappeared, but now it has appeared again because new proposals have already been provided. We review them to make sure that the proposals are correct. Then in the same way, select them all and confirm. As you can see, this is a very efficient process. In this way, we will be able to mark thousands of faces in our photo archive in a short time. Now let's talk about what information you can store in the Tonfotos database about specific people. Let's start with the simplest, with the avatar. By default, the very first portrait that you added to this person is used as the profile picture. But it's not always the best. Therefore, it can be changed. Let's say I like this photo. Let's click on it and select Use as Avatar from the context menu. And then it will change. It has been replaced not only in the header, but also in the information panel. Now, in all photos where there is a face of this person, this avatar will be shown. Also note that we can navigate through our library by clicking on those portraits that are already assigned to people. You can see that the program goes to the right person and to the right portrait. However, if we double-click on the portrait instead of clicking once, we will not be taken to a specific photo, but to the very beginning of the photo section of this person. This will also open a section with additional information about the person. You can also open this panel with this button, so it hides and reveals itself. Here you can see how much you can save, including you can leave an arbitrary text comment. It also supports connections between people. We can specify who is related to whom. For example, let's add the information that Andre and Helen are married. Now I can switch to Helen, and as you can see, Andre is automatically added as a spouse. We can go further. Let's add children, Alice and Leonid. This feature can be very useful for those who are interested in their family history, collecting information about ancestors. With it, you can link all the information together and tag everyone in the photo. For the purposes of this tutorial, I have used a very small and very simple database of photographs based on a single photo session with a small number of people, in good light, and taken with a professional camera. But if you use your entire archive of photos, then you will inevitably come across low-quality face photos. For example, people photographed in poor light, at a great distance, or whose faces are turned away from the camera, or partially blocked by foreign objects, and so on. Such faces are sometimes quite difficult, even for a person to unambiguously identify, and they undoubtedly present a difficulty for artificial intelligence as well. There may be situations where for a certain person in your library, the percentage of low-quality portraits is high, and this may lead to a situation where the faces of other low-quality people may be offered as candidates for that person. To avoid having to waste time rejecting such offers, Tonfotos has added a special offer less suggestion feature that can be enabled via the context menu in the list of people. You can also reverse it later if you want. And this concludes our lesson. We have reviewed all the main functions related to working with faces in the Tonfotos application. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please subscribe to our channel and leave a like. Thank you for your attention and have a nice day.